Speech of Defense by Jose P. Rizal. Señores, I do not intend to speak at length. I am convinced of my innocence. But there are statements made, and I feel they should be refuted. No one can do this better than myself. I have been accused of founding the La Liga Filipina. I admit, I wrote the statutes for the La Liga Filipina and that I called the first meeting. However, I absolutely deny that its purpose is revolutionary. In that first and only meeting, we discussed ways and means of advancing Filipino industry, commerce, agriculture, and education, and securing our liberties by peaceful means. Señores, you who once fought for your own liberties, why should you condemn our aspiration for those liberties, which you tell the world you have given us? Besides, the La Liga Filipina had but one meeting. When I was deported to the Pitan, the La Liga Filipina died. Who of you will say that in that meeting, I, a poor Indio, could have conceived and set into motion such a vast conspiracy, which today is costing Spain untold efforts to suppress, and costing us untold miseries? If the La Liga Filipina had revolutionary and sanguinary aims, if I was the recognized leader, if, as the prosecution for the Crown had so dramatically said, I was adored by its members as some sort of superior being, why should the members, soon after I was deported, let the La Liga Filipina die and establish the Katipunan to take its place? Señores, it is clear that the La Liga Filipina had aims different from those of the Katipunan. Today, I realize that most probably you are prejudiced against me, embittered by what I have said in my writings. Yet, at the same time, I am convinced of your sense of justice. If I have said bitter things, it was because at that time, I was embittered by the sight of the suffering and miseries that my family was undergoing. Can you blame me for being bitter? If you think that I have exploited that fully in my 4 years of exile in the Pitan, I ask those who knew me intimately during those 4 years of exile, the commandants and the Jesuit missionaries of the Pitan, I ask them, if my conduct ever gave the slightest semblance of one who in his heart was plotting the overthrow of Spain in the Philippines. Señores, I repeat, I am innocent of any part in this rebellion. I have always condemned bloodshed as a means of obtaining our liberties. I cannot deny that from my very childhood, I hope to see my native land enjoy those rights and liberties which are necessary for the peace and progress of our country. I cannot deny that I have always looked forward to the day when Filipinos, culturally, economically, and socially, will be ready to guide their own destiny to the nobility of Spain, and with God's providence, take your place among the free nations of this world. If by rebellion, senores, you mean this present bloody insurrection against the government, once more I say, I am not guilty! But if by rebellion, you mean to hope and to desire to labor and struggle by every peaceful means for the liberties of my country, and if for that you demand the penalty of death, then gladly, willingly, shall I die. Thank you.